It was a time of pharaohs, a time of monuments. It was a time of wealth and a time of slavery. As the great pharaoh ruled his kingdom, so did his slaves, the Hebrews, build it. There were so many of these slaves that fear gripped Pharaoh's heart.
These Hebrews, these children of Israel, I don't like them. Not at all.
Not at all.
Terrible people.
Not at all like us.
There are too many of them. They could start their own army, try to overthrow us. Perhaps it's time to thin out their herd. I decree that they work harder, harder. Make them work until they drop.
Scribes? Scribes!
We have a decree from Great Pharaoh!
But the slaves survived, and Pharaoh still feared them.
Yet they thrive! Work them harder still. I will break their will, break their hearts. I will bring them down, as Ra has told me. Summon the guards! Go out and find every Hebrew baby boy! Throw them all into the Nile! Let the crocodiles have them. Then these slaves shall know who is Pharaoh, who is their god. They shall fear me. They shall worship me, immortal Pharaoh.
Guards! Guards!
But now the Spirit of God moved in the land. He was about to help his children. Jochebed, wife of Amram, gave birth to a boy. She was not going to let him die.
My son will live.
We've hidden him 3 months, dear. I don't know how much longer we can...
We've made him a basket, haven't we, Miriam?
A good basket, too. It'll float. I help.
You did a fine job, too, Aaron.
He'll be able to get away. Get away from Pharaoh.
Open up!
Miriam, Aaron, hide your little brother. Out back, now.
If this is about the loud singing, I can explain all that.
Never mind.
But I should be out there protecting him!
Tonight, that's not what God would want.
Well, what does God want, then?
For you to wait. You'll be together later. You'll protect him someday. God talks to us all, Aaron. We have only to listen. You will hear him one day.
May God guide you, my son.
Nobody's going to hurt my baby brother.
Thank you.
Pharaoh's daughter, the royal princess.
Bring me that basket.
I look like a fish. I look like a great swimmer. Go get your new basket.
This is one of the Hebrews' children. But now he is mine. The gods have given me a son, and he will be known as my son and a prince over all men. Because he was drawn from the water, his name shall be Moses.
Your Highness?
Yes, child. You may approach me.
Oh, he's cute. Will you be needing a nurse for him?
Oh, why, yes. Yes, I will.
I know just the woman.
Then bring her to me. This will be our little secret. You are destined for great things, Moses. I feel it in my heart. My son.
Don't you give up, Moses. I'm too much for you.
I'd never give up.
You should learn to. See how a true prince wrestles.
Ramses, is this the way a future leader behaves?
No, Father.
Moses, you are not destined to reign over Egypt, but you're still a prince, my grandson. Act as a prince. But you, Ramses, my son, a future pharaoh, you disappoint me. You have responsibilities. You are in charge of the monuments. Get back to the palace. Both of you.
I didn't mean to get us into trouble, cousin.
You're always getting me into trouble. I'm tired of it.
I'm sorry, Ramses.
Well, you will be. Believe me, you will be.
Get going, faster!
Like it, Father?
You've done a fine job, my son.
Thank you, Father. The years of work and the slaves lost were worth it if it brings you pleasure. I am the only true prince in the House of Pharaoh.
Indeed you are.
You will be a god forever in the eyes of Egypt.
Thanks to you, my son.
Let me help you.
No, Your Highness. If Pharaoh ever found out that a prince...
did a good deed, I don't think he'd mind. That will be a beautiful tree one day.
Yes, Your Highness. Thank you, Your Highness.
Every bit of flesh off of your miserable body.
Hey, you! Stop that! Stop! That's enough of that.
This is none of your business. I beat these dogs all the time. It's the law of the land.
And the law is unjust. That's a man, not a dog. And a civilized man should not hurt even a dog. That's just not right.
You need to be taught a lesson.
You'd kill Pharaoh's grandson?
I'd kill anyone who mocks Pharaoh's law. And by the looks of you, you're no royal grandson.
I've killed him.
Oh, run, lad. Run. The Pharaoh will slay you for this deed.
But I can explain it to him. He's my grandfather.
No, he's not.
I know you. You're Aaron, son of my nurse, Yogabed.
She's not your nurse. She's your real mother. Huh.
But I'm a prince of Egypt.
Do you not remember the river? The basket, the blanket your own mother gave you.
I dream of these things, but...
it all happened.
Then Jochebed's daughter, Miriam?
Your sister, my sister. We both love you. Now you must ride for your life.
No, I'm a prince of Egypt.
Why would I lie? Trust me, Moses, trust me. Haven't you always felt different deep down inside?
Yes, but...
take this donkey. Flee while you still can.
But... well, what about you? Miriam, my family.
We'll survive. We always have. We always will. Put this on and go. Now! Here come the guards. We'll see each other again, my brother. I know it. I feel it.
Don't worry, you get his way!
Hey! Yeah! Yeah!
be with you, my brother.
You are no longer a prince of Egypt, Moses.
Ramses, surely Pharaoh...
He has granted you your life. I wouldn't have. There is your scepter. You are now a prince of the desert. Begone from Egypt, Moses. Be the prince of the scorpions, the locusts, and the buzzards.
I'm sorry I got you into this, donkey. Water? You smell water? Hey! Wait for me! Hey!
Our goats are thirstier.
Out! Before we do you harm!
The women were there first. Wait your turn. Or deal with me.
Be off!
I'm a dead man to Pharaoh, and my donkey has a bad temper. So why don't you leave now? Let the women tend to their sheep. The two of us... We have nothing to lose or to fear.
Would you like to share our water?
I'd be honored.
Do you have a name?
Moses.
I am Zipporah, daughter of Jethro. Are you a Hebrew?
No. Yes. I'm just a stranger in a strange land.
Come. My father will want to thank you for saving us.
So Moses settled in the land of Midian. And kept the flocks of Jethro. And Jethro gave Moses his daughter Zipporah as a wife. And they had two sons. Moses was happy. But in Egypt, the children of Israel cried in their bondage. And their cry came up to God, and God heard them. And God chose Moses to lead them out of their servitude.
Oh, you like those flowers? Don't eat all of them. We wouldn't want you to have a stomach ache now, would we? No. There's one in every flock. Be careful, little one.
Little one, be careful.
I've never seen anything like that. I've got to take a closer look.
You probably have more sense than I have, little one. A fire that doesn't harm the bush.
And when he had climbed to the place, God called to him out of the midst of the fire.
Moses. Moses. Moses.
I'm here. I'm right here.
Take off your shoes, for you are standing on holy ground.
I've taken off my shoes. Sir?
I am the God of your fathers. The God of Abraham, and the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob. I have seen the affliction of my people who are in Egypt, and I have heard their cries, for I know their sorrows. Therefore I will send you, Moses, to free them, and you will bring my people to serve me upon this mountain.
Who am I, Lord, to do this? If I go back to Egypt and say I'm sent by God, nobody will believe me. They'll ask me, what God? What's this God's name? What will I tell them?
I am that I am. You will say, I am has sent me to you. This is my name forever, and they will believe you. Now go. I will be with you.
Lord, they're going to need more than my word.
Moses, cast your staff onto the ground. Now pick it up by the tail. Put your hand inside your robe and draw it out.
My hand, it's diseased.
Put your hand back inside your robe and draw it out again. Show the people these signs, and they will believe. Give them my message, and they will follow you out of Egypt to this mountain, and then you will lead them to their true home, a land that will flow with milk and honey for them all.
Lord, I trust your judgment, but I'm not that great a speaker.
Use your brother Aaron to help you. Do as I have instructed, Moses. I will be with you.
You'll need this. Please, don't leave us, Moses.
God has spoken. I must go.
Will we ever see you again?
Of course you will. You must have faith.
We do, Moses. We do.
Is anybody there? Show yourself, villain.
Moses, is that you?
Show yourself.
Moses.
Aaron? My brother. How did you know?
I had this dream. God told me to meet you here.
It was no dream, my brother. We have to do as he has commanded.
We go to Pharaoh? We have a new Pharaoh. Arrogant, hateful, a slave master. You once called him cousin.
Ramses. I haven't seen him in years.
He's not going to want to see you. I told my dream to our people. They know you've come to lead them to the land of milk and honey. To deliverance. To freedom.
Aaron, I'm glad you're with me. I'm going to need all the help I can get.
I will always be by your side, Moses.
Thank you, my brother.
You will stay with Miriam and me tonight. You have much to do tomorrow.
Baby brother! Welcome back! Welcome home! Oh, if only our parents could have lived to see this day!
It's good to be home, Miriam. Finally home.
Moses, welcome.
The elders wanted to meet you. Come, come! We all want to hear what God has told you.
I have come to see Pharaoh.
Pharaoh doesn't see Hebrews.
Toss this riffraff away from Moses?
Ramses, I come on urgent business. I come as a representative of God.
Moses the murderer. Moses the coward. My sister died mourning you.
I'm sorry.
You've always been a sorry excuse for a prince, Moses. There is only one true prince of Egypt, and now he is Pharaoh. You smell of sheep. Let them both wait until all the incense in the palace has been lit.
Well, at the very least, we're getting an audience with Pharaoh.
Spoke to me. And as was told to me, the Lord God of Israel says, let my people go.
Moses, you expect me to just let the Hebrews leave? Just like that? Because a God I do not know, have never heard of, wants me to? You've been in the desert too long. Look at you, with your tawdry robe and your splintered staff. You're pathetic in my eyes, but then you've always been pathetic. A murderer, a coward, a fraud. As for your Lord God, Pharaoh is the god of Egypt. There is no other.
Show him. Show him the sign.
Behold the power of the Lord God.
It's just a trick, my son. Watch and see.
Even my magicians can outdo your so-called god.
Our magicians are better.
Hear me, Pharaoh. The Lord God has commanded it. Let my people go.
Tell your God that Pharaoh will not release his slaves. They barely work as it is, and you would have me set them free. No. Tell your God that I will increase their work. I will no longer give them straw to make their bricks. They will have to find their own straw. And if they don't meet their quotas, they will die. They will die by day's end. Tell your God that, Moses. Arrogant fool.
Father?
Oh, he's just a nuisance. Nothing for you to worry about.
Anyone who doesn't meet his quota of bricks will die by sundown. More bricks! More bricks!
What's this?
Hold your tongue. They're led by Dathan. He's Pharaoh's spy.
Pharaoh has Hebrews as spies?
You've been away a very long time.
Are you happy now? They're working us harder.
They're killing us!
All you've done is make everything worse. Go to Pharaoh, apologize. Say you made a mistake.
Yeah, maybe you misunderstood what God said. Maybe you got it all wrong. Go tell Pharaoh you were wrong. We didn't ask for your help. Apologize. Apologize now!
Moses? Moses! Dathan, you would put your needs above God's will?
God's will? Look around you, Aaron. God has abandoned us.
Lord God, I did everything you told me, but I only made things worse.
Moses, go again to Pharaoh. I will make you like a god to him. Take your staff and stretch forth your hand upon the river. You shall multiply my wonders in the land, and in this shall they know that I am the Lord.
Pharaoh, the Lord God has commanded you to let his people go.
Ah, the Lord God of trickery again. Out of my way, Moses, or I'll trample you.
Behold his power!
And Moses did as the Lord commanded. He lifted up his staff in the sight of Pharaoh and struck the waters, and all the river turned to blood. Throughout all the land of Egypt, the waters turned to blood, and the fish died, and the rivers stank, and the Egyptians could not drink.
Another clumsy bit of magic? Fine. You've poisoned the water. I don't need to drink water when I have wine.
Your heart is hard, Pharaoh. But my God is stronger. The Lord God has instructed me. I will show you that he is the one true God. Pharaoh, cousin, let my people go. This doesn't have to happen. Your people will suffer. Some will die.
Enough! Pharaoh is the only god you have to fear, Moses. You'll be the one to die, cousin.
And he hit the dust of the earth with his staff, and the dust became lice. Pharaoh's magicians could do nothing. There were lice upon man and beast.
Pharaoh hears, but does not listen, Lord.
And frogs came up out of the river and spread over the land, and they died in the houses in heaps.
Frogs? This is all his God has to torment me with? Frogs?
Then there came swarms of flies. The cattle died, and the land stank.
Flies are nothing, Moses.
Moses does bad tricks.
Exactly. Bad tricks and nothing more.
Then, the people of Egypt were stricken with sores. Only the children of Israel were spared.
This is the finger of God.
We've called for Moses. He's here, right now.
Perhaps Pharaoh could get him to ask his God to leave us alone.
I am God. Never forget that.
Yes, Pharaoh. We're sorry, Pharaoh.
These are worse than the lice and the flies.
They speak wisely, Pharaoh. All of this will cease only when you do as the Lord God commands. Let my people go. Release them from their bondage.
Leave this place or die.
But Pharaoh would not listen. So Moses stretched his hand towards heaven, and the Lord rained hail upon the land. Fire ran along the ground. Then locusts came to destroy the crops. Then, a darkness came from God. For 3 days, the earth was covered by darkness. There was only light in Goshen, and the green things slowly died.
Moses.
His God is destroying your kingdom. The crops die. The cattle die. Please send for him, O great Pharaoh.
Bring me Moses.
Take this death from my kingdom!
How long will you wait before you see that this is all God's will? Don't hurt your people anymore. God commands you to let his people go. You've seen what the Lord God can do. Don't think that you are greater than God.
Who is this God of yours, Moses?
The Lord God of Abraham and of Isaac and of Jacob.
His name!
Jehovah.
I know no such name. I know no such God. If you don't want to see your people slain, leave this house!
The Lord God will bring one more plague upon Egypt. Tonight, at midnight, the Lord will descend upon your kingdom. He will kill every firstborn son, from the rich to the poor in your dungeons. Only the children of Israel will be spared. Tomorrow, you shall set them free as your great nation mourns and asks, why didn't Pharaoh heed the words of the Lord God?
You are banished from this house! Banished! If I ever see your face again, I'll kill you!
I will mourn your loss, Ramses. Goodbye, Pharaoh.
Father, I'm the firstborn. I'm afraid.
Don't be. This man is nothing. His God is nothing. His people are nothing.
Then why am I still scared?
Then Moses called for all the elders of Israel, and he said to them,
God has spoken to me. This day is the beginning of your journey to the promised land. Tonight, you must eat nothing but unleavened bread and the meat of lamb. Let each of you take the blood of the lamb and mark your doors, and don't leave your homes until morning. For tonight, the Lord God will come, and he will deal with your oppressors and will shield you from the destroyer. When death sees the mark of lamb's blood on your doors, he will pass over your homes. He will not hurt any of you. But once we leave this land, you must remember and celebrate this night. This night of the Passover.
And the people did as the Lord commanded.
Just passed us by.
Thank God.
Yes. But pity the firstborn of Egypt.
And at midnight it came to pass, as Moses said, all the firstborn of Egypt were struck. There was not a house where there was not one dead. And a great cry rose up.
God, Ra! No! Not my son! Not my son! Find Moses! Get me Moses! Moses! Moses!
All the Hebrews of Goshen were spared.
My friend, I'm so sorry.
You are not my friend. Say nothing to me. Go, take your people and go. Take our riches, I don't care. Serve your God and be gone.
We will go. The sons and daughters, the young and the old, the flocks and the herds will go. We all have seen that the Lord God Jehovah lives.
Moses, I will not forget what you have done to my kingdom and to me.
You, my brother.
God has blessed us all. Remember this day. This day, the hand of the Lord broke the chains of slavery. What?
I'm glad I guarded your basket. You cried your head off that night.
If it wasn't for you, perhaps God wouldn't have chosen me.
That's what big sisters are for. God works through us, too. And where are we going?
We go to the Promised Land.
Where is this Promised Land?
I don't know.
No map to guide us?
No.
Then how?
He will guide us. I have faith that he will lead the way.
And the Lord went before them as a pillar of cloud to lead the way by day, and by night, a pillar of fire.
Come on! This way! We camp here!
Moses, has God told you how we are to cross this vast sea?
Not exactly.
I wouldn't let too many people know that.
Our farms died. Our buildings are not being built. There's no one to tend our herds. Why have you set these slaves free?
You ordered it, great Pharaoh, after their god killed all of us.
I was a fool. It was a moment of weakness. How could I let Moses and his god best me? There is only one god, Pharaoh. I am the only god. Summon the chariots. We will pursue the Hebrews. The ones we don't kill, we capture.
What about Moses?
Moses is mine. I want to watch him die.
What do you mean, Dathan?
This is suicide!
Yeah! You've led us into the wilderness to die!
I always said you didn't know what you were doing. Always!
You've led us into a trap. We can't fight Pharaoh.
Enough! Pack your things. Be ready to move.
But Pharaoh! We can't fight Pharaoh!
The Lord shall fight for you.
I wonder what God told him.
I'm sure we're gonna find out soon.
Moses. Moses, I've got you now.
At my command, we attack. Show no mercy.
Where's your God now, Moses? Hold. Hold.
Pharaoh!
Have your men go around the fire. Moses, you cannot stop me. You will die at my hands.
The Egyptians you see today, you will never see again. See how the Lord protects you.
Shall we go?
Yes, sister.
Come, children. Hurry, hurry.
Don't forget the wagon.
She wanted to see the fish.
Pharaoh's army! They're coming! They're coming!
I told you they'd kill us. Didn't I tell you? They'll kill us all, thanks to you.
Afraid. Behold the salvation of the Lord. There is no one like you, Lord. You've spun your winds and tossed your seas upon our enemies. You have saved your chosen people. You have taken us out of slavery, out of Egypt, like an eagle takes his young upon his wings.
Praise God!
On to the promised land!
So Moses brought Israel through the wilderness. They went many days and found no water. The people began to doubt.
What kind of trip is this? No food, no water?
You want to kill us? Is that the idea?
What kind of man are you?
Do you have any idea what you're doing?
You complain. You always complain. Hasn't God taken care of you like a father does his children? Hasn't he promised you a great land to call your home? A land of water, of green valleys and hills? Hasn't he promised you all of this?
But we're hungry.
And thirsty.
Really thirsty.
Are we there yet?
And the people wept all that night, crying.
Moses, we're thirsty!
Moses, we're hungry!
Why have you and God taken us to this horrible place?
Now, at least the Egyptians fed us
and gave us water.
I have an idea. Let's go back. If God really talks to you, tell him we're dying out here.
My wife's not happy, that's for certain.
Didn't you do anything?
If God provides you water, will you stop whining?
Well, yes, but there's no water around here.
See how God loves you.
Water! Hey, everyone! Water! Water! While you're at it, we could use some food. Got any ideas?
Lord, these people are driving me mad. I just don't understand what you want me to do. I'd appreciate your help.
I have heard the murmurings of Israel. Come morning, I will rain food from the heavens for you. Speak to them and say so.
Children of Israel, God has heard your cries. Tomorrow morning, you will see.
Oh.
Mother, father, come look.
And in the morning it was so. On the ground lay food, like the frost.
This is the bread the Lord has given you. It is manna, bread from heaven. Take it, eat it. Let your stomachs be full. Thank you, Lord.
It tastes like honey.
Eat. Eat and let's march.
How much further, my brother?
That way, towards that mountain.
As God knows it.
Go ahead. Go ahead.
Well, why hasn't God given us any meat?
All we get is manna. Manna, manna, manna. The Egyptians gave us meat.
We had fish and cucumbers and melons.
Cucumbers and melons aren't meat.
I meant beef and lamb.
We always had beef and lamb.
Yeah,
we did.
We had a wide variety of foods to choose from.
I mean, let's face it, a little manna goes a long way.
Why, I couldn't have put it any better myself.
But you told us what to say.
Lord, what can I do with these people? I can't take it anymore. All day long, all night long, what do I hear? Give me this, give me that. Give me bread, give me water, give me meat. Lord, there is no meat out here.
Is my power doubted? Go and tell them they shall have food.
Thank you, Lord. I have spoken to the Lord. He will give you meat, not just for one day or 10 days, but for a whole month, until it comes out of your ears, because you questioned why you were led out of Egypt. Enjoy your meal. Joshua, my young general.
I merely fight for God, Moses. I'm no general.
Come, sit by me, boy. One day, a general you will be. God has told me you will do great things for our people.
Really?
God tells me many things.
Well, thank you, Moses. Well, thank you, sir.
Would you tell Aaron and Miriam I'd like to speak with them?
Yes, sir.
You sent for us?
Sit, brother and sister, sit. You both seem troubled.
Moses, you promised too much.
Don't worry. Everything will be fine.
I know you think God only speaks to you, but he speaks to us too. I never heard him mention anything about meat.
If you were able to empty all the seas of all the fish, there still wouldn't be enough to feed all of our people.
Once you both believed.
Hear now my words, my children. I speak to everyone who believes in me, but to Moses I make myself known. I chose Moses as my servant among all, for he is the most humble man on earth. So to Moses, I speak face to face.
Never forget God's plan.
Quail! Out here?
They are here because God said they'd be.
Look, the meat.
Come on. I hope you like quail. We'll be getting a lot of it for the next month. Me, I don't like quail all that much.
Oh, this strange place?
The place the Lord first appeared to me.
Moses?
God wants me there, again.
I'm afraid.
Don't be. Come. Come, we'll make camp here. Can you not hear it? It is the voice of God. Do not be fearful. One day, you will all be able to open your hearts to his voice. Now, I must go up on the mountain and talk with God.
Be careful, Moses.
I am with God. Watch over our people. They may grow restless.
I will, my brother.
I'm coming with you.
Now I feel safer. Joshua, I must go alone from here.
I'll wait for you, Moses.
And he climbed up into the thick cloud where God was. He stayed 40 days and 40 nights. Darkness covering the glory of the Lord.
Moses has deserted us. He's been up there forever. He's dead, I tell you. Dead!
He'll never come back.
No. He'll come back.
But what if he doesn't? What if he dies up there? What will we do? We'll all die here. All of us.
Aaron, make us a god. A real god. A god who... who lead us to the promised land!
Yes! I can't do that.
Make us a god, or die on that mountain with your brother. Or die down here with your sister.
Miriam?
God will forgive you.
But will Moses?
Break off the golden rings from the ears of your wives and your daughters. Bring them to Aaron. Get all that Egyptian gold, yeah. And get their silver, too. Their jewelry. Yeah, that's the way. Aaron will make us a real god. Golden calf. Who needs Moses and his invisible god? Not me. Not you. Come on. Come on. Give us that jewelry. All of it.
God, forgive me for what I do.
Here is your God, children of Israel.
Let's all dance and sing and give praise to our new God, a God we can all see face to face. Not like Moses' private God.
Moses, I give to you the way to live. I give to you my 10 commandments. Remember them. Teach them. Teach them for the rest of time.
Moses.
I am the Lord your God. You shall have no other gods before me. You shall not worship false gods. You shall never take my name in vain. You shall keep the Sabbath day holy. Honor your father and your mother. You shall not murder. You shall not commit adultery. You shall not steal. You shall not lie. You shall never want what belongs to others.
Sounds like someone's attacking the camp.
It's not war we hear. It's a celebration. Too far this time.
It's Moses!
Moses!
So it's Moses. We don't need him anymore. We have our own God, right here. Look, it sparkles. You see how it sparkles? It's gold. Gold, gold!
Moses.
Thank God.
This is how you repay the Lord? He brought you out of slavery. He led you across the desert. He parted the seas to let you live. And yet, you doubted him. I call on heaven and earth to see what you have done.
Oh, what are you afraid of? A little bad weather? Well, we could use some rain, right? Right? I mean, it's dry out here.
Don't you realize he loves you? He gave these to us. His commandments. All who believe in the Lord. All who are on his side. Come to him. Walk towards me.
Yes.
Well, are you people crazy? We have a golden god right here. All Moses has is a couple of rocks. Rocks! Well, you can find rocks anywhere. He says those rocks are God's laws. They're Moses' laws. Moses wants to be like Pharaoh. Well, he thinks he's better than everybody else.
Today, you will witness the judgment of the Lord. Forgive them. They're sorry. If you're still angry, if you want to punish anyone, punish me first.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
Yes.
his laws. They're destroyed.
I will go back to the mountain. God will provide us another set. But this time, when I'm away, I have something a little better for you to build. Come, I have instructions for you from above.
We must construct an ark to house the tablets. And we must construct a tabernacle so that God may dwell in our midst.
All Moses does is talk with God. He should pay more attention to us.
He should pay more attention to where we're going.
Well, surely he's gotten us lost.
How long will these people disobey me? How long will they turn their backs on all I have done for them? Perhaps I should just abandon them.
Lord, everyone in the land knows how powerful you are. The plagues, the parting of the sea. Show how powerful your love is. Please, pardon the sins of these people because of your unfailing love.
I will pardon them, Moses. But not one of them will see the promised land. They will all wander the wilderness until the last of their generation is gone. Their children and their children's children will make the final journey without them.
And the sins of the children of Israel caused them to wander in the wilderness for 40 years. Until all the older generation that would not believe perished.
Moses, it's Miriam. She's...
I know.
She died in her sleep.
That is good.
All the old ones
are embarking on another journey. Are you in pain?
No. I'll be seeing God's face soon.
You've been the best of brothers, Aaron. You helped me. Stayed by my side.
We really caused Pharaoh some problems. You remember?
The snake.
And those flies. I think the flies were my favorite. Whoa, Pharaoh hated those flies. God has a great sense of humor. Don't be sad, Moses. We were blessed. We were chosen by God. Soon our people will see the promised land. That is a great thing.
Aaron,
with the Lord, as I will be too, very soon.
But Moses, this makes no sense.
The new world, it belongs to those who believe and to those who have the courage to enter it.
But the Lord chose you.
One time, I failed him. So, justly, I was punished. He will allow me to see the promised land. But not to enter it. That is to be my reward, Joshua. And a wonderful reward it is.
But the Lord...
Just mention me. Once in a while to your children. Moses, God's humble servant.
Moses?
Let me speak to the children of Israel one last time.
Yes, Moses. Children of Israel, God has told me I must die in this land. Joshua will be your leader now. You will all cross over and live in the promised land. And the Lord will be with you all. He will watch over you, and you will lack nothing. You will have food, and you will have homes. And your fields will sprout. They will be plentiful. And so are your cattle and sheep. But you should never forget this journey. Never forget God's words. Keep them in your heart. Remember all that He has given us. And if you sin, ask His forgiveness. He will grant it to you. Why? Because He loves us all. It's time that you cross the River Jordan. Go on to the promised land. This is what He brought you here for.
Moses, lead them. My great general, lead them.
Will you be all right?
Better than all right.
On to the promised land! Onward! Over Jordan!
Coming, Lord. Coming. I am ready.
This is your place, Moses. This is your place.
So Moses died there. No one knows his resting place until this day. But there hasn't been a prophet since like Moses. The only man who knew the Lord God face to face.